And also this morning, we also straight down at 12 o'clock. But then just in the aircraft, we had an extra ride around about 3, just into my helicopter. Very kindly supplied by Reviera, so sure we can bring me here today. Well, the T-Rose of Red Arrows is, of course, the best at Royal Air Force. One of the questions I get asked a lot is when you leave the Red Arrows, you can join the Royal Air Force. Of course, Royal Air Force Red Arrows are still part of the Red RAF. We just in any of the squadrons, we are commanded by Officer Commanding the rank there, Red Arrows, which is Wing Commander Adam Collins. Some of you might remember him. He was my predecessor. He was Red 10 before me. He went away for a year. He took over as MC Ratback this year. Wing Commander Collins is a former Tornado DR4 pilot. He also flew the F-111 on exchange runs with the Royal Australian Air Force. And he also flew the whole T-Mark-1 at the Aggressor role at RAF, leaving with 100 squadrons. But of course, the Red Arrows represent the RAF, and what the RAF is on duty 365 days a year, 24/7, protecting the skies, defending the airspace above our allies. And of course, it's not all about protecting airspace, we also aid in the humanitarian era and helping out, as you've seen that over the last year or so, with numerous humanitarian missions with C-17s to Gabon and places like that. Because the RAF is a force for good, it secures the air and space to maintain peace, and delivering the humanitarian aid and support where it is needed. We've had a busy season last year. We were about 59 displays. This year, it's pretty much exactly the same. 60 displays, and over 15 official flight paths. And last year, it culminated in our tour around the Middle East, because of course, Red Arrows not only represent the RAF, but we represent global Britain. And we mix with light, the red, white, and blue, through the sky, promoting business, trade, and industry all across the world. I saw in the Middle East last year.